into a place where you feel like nobody needs you.
I don't own none of these rights.
Nobody believes you. I know what it feels like for people to tell you to write the book.
So, first set. One set of 20 each. So we're going to do hop squats, kickbacks, fire hydrants, pointed kicks, and marches. Then we're going to go into one of each, 45 seconds each. We're going to do the ab roller, we're going to do plank, punch it back. If you ain't got that, just substitute. And then a speed bag, if you ain't got that, substitute. And then just pull that. Then we're gonna go to 45 seconds each jump rope. Then it's gonna be left handed first, jab jab, and then cross to the right. Then again, jump rope, and then rotate, right, right, left, jump rope. Then we're gonna go to 2 sets of 15 each barbells, overhead press, hammer curls, kettlebell twists, and side lats on each side. And then the last thing that we're gonna do is 2 times 15 band curls, single arm bands. I want it to go like this though, so like this. Then band leads, so like just like this. Not like Indy Crit. We just building it up. Because eventually we're gonna go to this. Not there, so we're starting to look. Alright. So, here we go. Rotate to the right
about yourself.
You were doing the right, rotate to the left.
You've been selling yourself short all of your life. You have the opportunity to experience more environmental, physical, and mental abundance. Someone who is in a constant state of elevation. Their self is, I know who I am, I know where I'm going, and I know where I came from. I want to continue the conversation of self-awareness. You know, there are quotes that I love, and I want to share with you, and then it turns to the conversation of self-awareness. The quote is, there is definitely a direct connection between finding your passion
and
doing work you despise. Passion gives you an
advantage.
Because one person with passion is greater than 99.
Woo! Rotate to the right. If you were doing it right, rotate to the left.
Energy. Are you aware of what you are doing with your day-to-day time and grind? Do you like your current relationships? Do you like your subordinate rules? Do you like your
control?
I think a lot of us are programmed to hold
on. Woo! crutches. Or you like squeezing, you just squeezing inside, you're like, why does it feel weird?
You do it. Into I have a thingy on. I like it though. Alright. Here we go. Good. Does it take a moment? You can't do it all the way. This is what I need you to look like. So
that.
Don't want your back fall like that. That hurts more than you try to keep your stuff tight. It's all about keeping it tight. Keep it tight.
Do you like what you're doing if you like where you're going? Let me ask you another question. What would you like to do? If you don't like what you're doing, you don't like where you are, you don't like your relationships, and you don't like X, Y, or Z, what do you want? What do you like? And then you're going to be able to add passion to it.
It's just because it's starting late.
Are you fully aware of the dreams that are required to
do it? Breaks. Go.
Playing. A lot of people, they have this vision in their head, this dream, but they don't know how to make it.
Squeeze your butt cheeks. That's how you know you're doing it right. And then tuck in. Squeeze everything inside.
Raise the gap between dream and reality. So do you know what is required of you? Are you
you're shaking. No, you got this. Close your eyes and just envision the end. Envision what you're going to look like. Envision during this rough time, you're going to get yourself a 6-pack, or 8-pack, or 12-pack, whatever your goal is, 4-pack, 2-pack, I don't care. Imagine. Hold it. Ready? Heavy bag. Here we go. I'm going to do my hand because my fingers are covered. Thank you.
did conquer it. So then it means. This is for the rest of your life. This is to survive. You're not doing it for looks, charm, wealth. You're doing this for health, for life, to conquer, to overcome, to be the best motherfucker you can be, because that's who you are. There's only one of you. There's not two, there's not three. You may be a twin, but let me tell you something. You'll definitely have different personalities, each and every one of you. So I want y'all to keep up. Keep going. When you think you can't do it, don't stop. Don't let them know you're tired. Don't let them know you're weak. You hold on. You keep going. That's right. Ready? Grab that apple. Reset that bad boy. Boom. Let's go. Know who you are. Know who you are. Overcome everything you ever had thrown at you. Let them know that you come to grind. You come shine. You come to let them know that you are a beast. That's right. You are defined by who you are, how you do things, and what you overcome. Ready? You have to speed back yourself. It's time to move it out the way. Grab yourself a quick water if you need to. Not a lot though. But probably the room temperature. You're not gonna slow your core down. Let's go. You ready?
Welcome to the club.
That
when you
go.
I can write my own book, I can have my own business. I can trip and travel around the world. It's possible.
All right,
I can bounce back from adversity and reinvent my life. It's possible. Regardless of where I am, the thing can get better for me.
It's possible. It, kind of. Amazing. Where'd they go?
You
Trying to design a shirt while we're working out. Look at that.
It's not what happens in the game. It's what happened before the game. And it's what's going to happen after the game. It's what you see versus what actually is happening. Kobe Bryant did arrive on court 5 seconds before the game. And hopefully he's going to make that shot. He made that shot 1,000 times before. That's why they have a mystique about it. An essence of magic. Almost superhuman. You're witnessing the results. You're not watching 12 hours he's in the gym. The weeks, the months, the years. You just watch one game. That's why you think they're magic. Success is made in the gym. Success is made in the training. Success is made through the hard work and dedication. Success ain't the result. Success is the journey. Success is the days, the months, the years you put in. That's what success is. So we keep working towards these stars and inspirational people and seeing their results and thinking that's what success is. But success was the journey. Success was getting out of dirt. Success was coming from the bottom. You don't start your story at the top. You didn't really play those 10 hours, 12 hours every single day. It ain't gonna happen overnight. You ain't gonna arrive one day in front of a hoop with 5 seconds left to win the championship ring and hit that shot. It ain't gonna happen. It's the process before. It was a process before they got Kobe in. It was a process before they got Michael in. It was a process before they got Kelly in.
We need to survive, dude. You think those great musicians take over the job and stop playing? Start rolling after hits after hits after hits? Hell no. 10 hours a day, 12 hours a day, fingers bleeding, sweat on the drum skins. You may have torn out your hands, minute after minute, hour after hour, breath after breath, song after song. It don't happen at the corners. You're watching the pinnacle. You're watching all their work come together. That's why it seems magic. That's why it seems like you can't do it, but you can. Stop looking at the end result. What you want is an opportunity to shoot that shot. You don't see that. You see the blood. You don't see the sweat. The tears.
I'm only past 15.
You don't see the crying. The lost faith.
Some of it was sloppy.
You don't see the ruin. See the sights. You don't see lost friends. You don't see the world of pain.
Go.
You don't see the risk, the implications this might have. You don't see the lost opportunities. You don't see it. All you see is one shot. That's all you see. You think Arnold arrived on the stage looking like Mr. Olympia?
Sidelines.
You really want that way.
Just like that. Excuse me, just like that.
Ain't nobody willing to put in the work for the result. Everybody wishing for the result. Understand? You ain't want to take the test. You just want an A plus. How you gonna get an A plus if you don't take the test? How you gonna take the test if you don't even practice? You don't even revise. You don't even study. It ain't gonna happen. Everybody wanna be like Mike. Ain't nobody wanna put in the work on Mike. Everybody wants to be the next big thing, the next superstar, but ain't nobody willing to put in the work. None of y'all willing to put in the work. And if you truly are, if you really put in the work, 10 hours a day, 12 hours a day, every single day, you might have a chance. You might be the one. You might just be. But it will never happen if you wish it. There ain't no place for wishing in this game.
Your fingers all the way sometimes. You don't have to squeeze yourself.
You have a chance.
Now you should do it. Not over here like this.
Your mind is an evil motherfucker. It's constantly fighting against you. It's the only thing in the history of the fucking world.
The mind is the battleground. It is the place where the greatest power is.
surrender. We live and we die by this. Every man that searches on his soul. People don't burn out because of what they do. People burn out because life makes them forget why they do it. We have a superhuman talent every day of the week. At a certain point, don't let your actions betray your words, man.
The person that you stop to become is stronger than any other.